JSON is a text-based format that was originally created for data interchange. It has been widely adopted by the industry and is now one of the most commonly used formats for data transfer over networks. In this tutorial, we will learn how to handle JSON data with SQL in Oracle database. Without wasting time, let's get started. But first, let me introduce you to an AI that can help you with your code. Thank you, Codium AI, for sponsoring this video. Codium is an AI-powered extension for VS Code and JetBrains. Here's a piece of code that I want to test. In this code, I'm trying to connect to my PostgreSQL using Python. Let's use Codium AI to test it. In your VS Code, go to Extensions and search for Codium AI. Install the extension named Codium Mate. Once you have done that, you will see Codium Mate options or a direct call to test this function right out the function definition in your code. If you click Options, you will be presented with a list of operations you can perform on your code. You can test, enhance, or improve your code using Codium AI. If you click Test this function, then Codium AI will write various possible test cases for your code, making it more robust. Find the direct link to Codium AI in the description. Go ahead, download it, and try it yourself. In JSON, data is stored in key-value pairs. This key-value pair is enclosed inside a pair of curly brackets. Keys are strings, and values can be any valid JSON type. Values can also be arrays. In JSON, arrays are stored inside square brackets. In short, each element of the array is separated by a comma. We can even have nested JSON data. By nested JSON, we mean a JSON object that contains other JSON objects. Now that we know about JSON, it's time to understand how we can use JSON in Oracle database. As we know, in a relational database, we need a table to store data. So let's quickly create a table. Here, I have created a table named Employees, which has three columns. The ID column is an identity column, meaning it allows you to automatically generate unique values for a column in a table. Next is employee underscore data, which will hold our JSON data. I have set its data type as CLOB, but if your JSON data is not that large, you can set its data type as varchar. The third column is created underscore add, a timestamp column that will store the row insertion time. In any relational database, the only way to insert data into a table is through the insert DML statement. That's what we will use to insert our JSON data in Oracle database. Let's do that. Here we are inserting data into only one column, employee underscore data, of the employees table. This is because the data in the first column ID and the last column created underscore at will be automatically inserted. Here is the proper insert into statement. Take a good look at it. I will give you 5 seconds. Then I will explain the intricacies of this statement. Let's go. Look carefully. First, we have our insert into keyword, followed by the table name and the column name into which we want to store our data. And then the values keyword. This is perfectly normal. After that, we have a pair of parentheses, inside which we have a pair of single quotes. Make sure to use single quotes, not double quotes. Inside the single quotes, we have a pair of curly braces. Inside that, we have our data in key value format. Make sure every key name is enclosed in double quotes. Key and values must be separated from each other using a colon. If you have more than one key value pair, each pair must be separated by a comma, but there should not be any comma at the end of the last key value pair. That is how we format simple JSON data. What if there is nested JSON? Let's understand that. For example, let's say we want to add department data into this JSON, and this department is a standalone JSON object. Let's go back to our insert into statement and add this JSON object to it. First, we add a comma at the end of the last key value pair in this statement. And then we add a JSON object named department to it. Ensure that every opening curly brace has a matching closing curly brace. Since the department is the last entry, it will not have a comma at the end. However, if you want to add more key value pairs into this JSON data after department, You must put a comma after its closing brace to separate it from the next entry. That is how we create a proper insert into statement to insert JSON data into a table in Oracle database. Let's execute and insert this data. Done. In any relational database, we use select statement, DML or DQL, to retrieve data from a table. Let's do that. If we use select asterisk, this will display the data stored in the table in its original format, which is not very readable. To retrieve keys and values in proper readable format, we can utilize some of Oracle's built-in functions. One such function is JSON underscore value. Let me show you how. Here, JSON underscore value is the function we use. Its first parameter is the column name, employee underscore data, where JSON data is stored following a comma. The next parameter is the key name, name, whose value we want to retrieve. In this function, we prefix the key name with a dollar sign and a dot operator. Lastly, I have assigned the result an alias, name. Similarly, you can fetch salary data from the JSON. You can use these alias to sort the data in the order by clause. However, you cannot use aliases directly in filtering the data in the where clause. To filter the data in the where clause, you need to use the entire function call. That's how we fetch data from simple JSON structure. Now let's move on to fetching data from a nested JSON object. In our case, the nested JSON object was department. Our goal will be to retrieve the name and location of the department. Let's do that. So far, the select statement is similar to the one we wrote earlier. However, if we try to execute it here, we will get null as a result. This is because of the ambiguous nature of the department object. Since it is a nested object, the compiler doesn't know which value of the key it should retrieve. Therefore, we need to clarify it to the compiler. Since we want to fetch the value of the key name from the department object, we have to specify this using dot notation, like this. Let's execute it. Here is our desired result. Similarly, we can fetch the location from the department JSON object. There you go. These are the basic operations that we can perform on JSON data in Oracle database. Make sure to subscribe to the channel to catch more advanced SQL tutorials. Also, I will be launching a book titled Mastering SQL Window Functions. Initially, only 100 copies of this book will be available. To grab your copy and receive a 50% discount coupon, subscribe to my channel. Most importantly, don't forget to like this video. See you soon. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.